أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد أفضل صلواتك بعدد معلوماتك وبارك وسلم وصل عليه So we were talking last night about Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah. So regarding Allah we said, this is not a quality name or attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this is his proper name. Number two, ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Both these attributes have been derived from word Rahm. And Rahm mean mercy, kindness. So literally, Rahman mean the kind and Rahim mean the kind one. So that's a repetition. But technically that is not. Rahman, Brother Nuruddin, in Arabic, we say, Allazi rahmatuhu shamilatun amma. Allazi, that Allah, whose mercy and kindness, that is inclusive. And Ar-Rahim, Allazi rahmatuhu Kamilatun khasa. That one whose kindness is perfect but specific. The first one that is inclusive in general, Ar-Rahman, kindness is inclusive in general, and Rahim, kindness is perfect and specific. Got it? So regarding worldly affairs, He is called Rahman. And regarding affairs in the hereafter, he is called Ar-Rahim. Because here in this world, he created the whole world. Yes, he is giving life to everyone, maybe his friend or his enemy. He provides provision to everyone, even those who do not believe in his entity. Yes or not? So that is his kindness, which is inclusive and general in this world. But in the hereafter, that is perfect and specific for true believers. And this idea is supported by dua of Sayyidina Ali, radiyallahu ta'ala an. He used to say, Ya Rahman al-Dunya wa Ya Rahim al-Akhirah. O the Rahman in this world and the Rahim in the hereafter. Rahman in this one and Rahim in the hereafter. And he is Rahim in Akhirah. Surah Al-Ahzab. Ayah number 43 and 44. هو الذي الله is that one يصلي عليكم وملائكته who sends his blessings on you and his angels also sends their blessing on you. Allah is that one who sends his blessing on you and his angels also send blessings on you. لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ That he may bring you out from darkness of disbelief to the light of true belief. Darkness of disbelief to the light of true belief. وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا And he is the ever kind to the believers. He is the most kind to the believers, the most merciful to the believers. But where?
تَحِيَّتُهُمْ يَوْمَ يَلْقَوْنَهُ Their greeting on the day. يَوْمَ يَلْقَوْنَهُ When they will meet him, salamun will be salam.
So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most merciful to the believers on the day of judgment, when Allah will greet the believers and He will say to them, Assalamu alaikum. When we say Assalamu alaikum, so it means that we are making a dua. Yes, when we say to someone Assalamu alaikum, so that is surety and that is dua. That is assurance and that is dua. When I say salam to you, Assalamu alaikum, peace be upon you, so it means I assure you that I don't want to harm you. That's assurance. I don't want to harm you. And number two, Assalamu alaikum, I invoke Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep you in peace. To keep you in peace. Got it? So we are asking Allah to keep you in peace when we say salam to each other. And when Allah says salam to you, Assalamu alaikum, peace be upon you. So He is also asking some entity to send His peace on you. No, He is saying the same to Himself. So it means that's assurance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Got it? Wakana bil mu'minina rahima. He is the utmost merciful to the believers, and His greeting to the believers will be yawma yalqawnahu salam. Got it?
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, Ar Rahman, the beneficent, Ar Rahim,
and the merciful.
Alhamdulillah.
Now, Alhamdu, these are two words, not one. Alhamdu is two words, Al and Hamd. That is, these are two words, Al and Hamd.
This Alhamdu
is written like this. So to analyze it, it is like this. This is one word.
Hamd mean praise. Got it? And this Al,
Fahim, the same Al,
yes, which makes an indefinite noun a definite one. So now Hamad, praise. When you say Alhamdu, the praise. What? The praise. That is literal meaning. But then this Al is used in four meanings. Alhamdu means a thing which is called praise. One meaning is anything which is called praise. Number one. Number two, all praises. Number three, the praise which is known to me, the speaker, and known to you, the hearer. When I speak, so Alhamdu, the praise which is known to me as I do speak about it, and to you as well, you are listening to. Got it? And number four, Alhamdu, the praise which I know. Got it? So we are taking the second one. Otherwise, all these four meanings here, that is okay. But the second one, that is very much suitable here. Alhamdu, all the praises. Alhamdu, all the praises. Yes. And then, Alhamdu Lillah. So this Alhamdu is Mubtada, or subject. In grammar, that is subject. And Lillah, that is Khabar, or predicate. Mubtada and Khabar are subject and predicate that constitute a sentence. Which? Nominal. Yes. It constitutes a nominal sentence, not a verbal sentence. Because a verbal sentence is either related to past or present or future.
But a nominal sentence is not related to any time. That is perpetual. That's what? That's perpetual. That's everlasting. If I will say Hamidullah, it means I praised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When? 1 year before. Yes? If I say Alhamdulillah, it means I pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I praise Allah now. Or I will pray him tomorrow or day after tomorrow. But when we say Alhamdulillah, so it is not related to any specific time. That is everlasting. That is perpetual. That is in the past, in the present, and in the future. So Alhamdulillah means all praises are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All praises are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are talking about the beauty of this building. Yes, what a beautiful structure this is. They have made this thing actually good. Ultimately, that's a praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the architect, the engineer, the mason, the carpenter, the painter, or whosoever may be, he is the creature of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Got it? So whatever skill or wisdom he has shown herein, that is a gift of Allah subhanahu, because the same guy, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will disturb only one single artery in his brain, not only that, he will not be knowing the structure or the building, he will not be knowing himself even. Got it? So actually that is the praise of whom? Allah. And that's why in hadith, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, when you got amazed by the beauty or greatness of anything, so say Allahu Akbar. Yes. You saw Niagara Fall, oh, boom. Yes. You saw Niagara Fall, yes. So never get amazed of Niagara Fall. Yes, its creator, Allah of Allahu Akbar. Yes. You saw what? Great Canyon? Great Canyon. You know what I'm saying? Wonderful. So you should say, Allahu Akbar. You went there and you saw Pacific or Atlantic and the waves. Yes. And you got amazed. Don't be amazed of those waves. Who? The creator. Allah. Subhanallahu Akbar. Got it? So ultimately, every praise goes ultimately to whom? To Allah. So that's why it is said,
Alhamdulillah, all praises are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
All praises. Another meaning?
Each and every praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
And do you mean that he is the deserving one? He is the eligible one. You are not giving him anything. That's his due right. When we say that is due to Allah, so you are not doing a lot. Oh, he praised Allah subhanahu. If you will not praise him, so then what? That's his due right. He is the deserving one. He is the eligible one. Yes, you have to do that. So that's why the proper translation of Alhamdulillah will be each and every praise is due to Allah. Or all praises are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Either this way or that way. Got it?
Alhamdulillah, all praises are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Now, this is a claim. This is what? This is a claim. This is a da'wah. And as you know, that each and every claim needs evidence or proof. You have to prove your claim. You have to prove your claim. Yes. Evidence to be provided to the court. That is responsibility of whom? The claimant. Who? The claimant. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a claim. Each and every praise is due to Allah. All praises are due to Allah. The evidence, the proof, why? Why all praises are due to Allah? Subhanahu. This claim itself is the evidence. This claim is itself? Huh? Is the evidence. So Alhamdulillah mean all praises are due to Allah because he is Allah. Because he is Allah. Yes. When you said, Akramtu Abawaya, I respected my parents. Or I do respect my parents. Yes, that's something which needs proof. Why you do respect your parents? So you should not bring anything from outside because they are my parents. You don't need to say, yes, because my mother, she was carrying me in her belly for 9 months. How difficult that burden was for my month. Yes, then she delivered me in difficulty. Then she was feeding me her breast. And then she was thinking of every comfort to be provided to me. And there is no need of such like things. Yes, akram to ummi, I respected my mom. Why? Because she is my mom. Yes, that's more than enough. That is more than enough. Got it? So alhamdulillah, all praises are due to Allah. Why? Because he is Allah. Because he is Allah. So our Shaykh Rahmatullahi Alayh, he used to say, Aftab Ahmad, Dalil-e Aftab. Yes, sun itself is sufficient proof for its existence. Yes, if you say that sun exists, does it need any evidence from outside? Yes, how you will prove that sun exists? Yes, our sun is rising. Sun itself is sufficient proof for its rising. It doesn't need any evidence from outside. Aftab Ahmad Dalil-e Aftab. Aftab Ahmad Dalil-e Aftab. Got it?
Alhamdulillah, all kinds of praises are, all praises are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
So dawa and dalil. Claim and proof. Got it? Now the second one.
Rabbil Alameen, the Lord of the universes.
Alameen is the plural of Alam. Alam mean universe and Alameen mean universes. So to us, the whole world is only one universe. No, this is not the case. Yes, there are different universes. Number one, Alamul Arz. Yes, this world on the ground. Yes, got it or not it? Alamul Falakiyat, the world of heavenly bodies. Alamul Aflaq, the world of skies. Alamul Malaika, the worlds of angels. Alamul Jinn, the world of jinn. Alamul Sahara, the world of deserts. Alamul Bihar, the world of oceans. Yes, and so on and so on. Alamul Tuyur, the world of birds. Alamul Haywanat, the world of animals. Alamul Hasharat, the world of insects. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used the plural. Got it?
Rabbil Alameen, the Lord of the universes.
So now the word Rabb is an attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which includes every single attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This word Rabb includes every single attribute of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It does not have any proper substitute in English language. We say Lord. Rabb mean Lord. But that's not the proper substitute. That's only a ta'bir. We are trying to. Yes? So now, what Rabb means, you have to mention a few words there. So you will have a little bit concept about Rabb. Number one, Lord. Number two, King. Number three, Ruler. Number four, Provider. Number five, Owner. Number six, Creator. Number seven, Master. Number eight, Originator. Number nine, Sustainer. Got it? So just name it. Number 10, giver of security. That is Rabb. And that Allah does everything. All these things are done by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you say Rabb, it includes all these concepts. Got it?
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen.
And as I told you, that in Alamul Arwah, in what? Alamul Arwah, world of spirits and souls. When all of us, from Adam up to the last human being until the day of judgment, the last human being who will come, the last one to this world. Yes? So all these billions and billions of human beings, their souls and spirits were created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all at once. We are coming one after the other. Our father, then we, then our kids, then their kids, and it will be going on. The same procedure is going on since the days of Adam, alayhi salatu wasalam. But as far as our souls and spirits are concerned, all these spirits and souls are created all at once. You should write it. These are created when with one word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, kun, be. Be. So all these trillions and zillions souls were there. And today, as I was mentioning in Jummah Khutbah, because that was our dars today in philosophy, that Imam says, Rahimahullah, Imam Waliullah, Rahimahullah, that is flesh of meat and bones. Flesh of meat and bones. Their nature is totally different than each other. Bone is utmost solid. And flesh of meat is utmost soft. Yes? So they will never go along with each other. You know what I'm saying? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in between the membrane. Yes? So a membrane, it is soft and it is solid. It has both the nature. So through its softness, it is holding the flesh of meat. Yes? And with its solid nature, it is holding the brain. So that is just like, as you know, the glue. That membrane is just like what? The glue for bone and flesh of meat. Got it? Not it? Or about it? Got it. Yes. So same is the case of human body and Ar-Ruhur Rabbani. Ar-Ruhur Rabbani. Our body. That is totally matter and material. That is what? Matter and material. But ruh, spirit and soul, that is totally immaterial. That is totally immaterial. And material and immaterial, they both does not go along. Got it? But still, we feel that our life is because of that ruh, or ruh Rabbani. Yes? That immaterial element, which is called ruh. Which is called ruh. So how they get together? In between, there is a third thing. That is called nasama. N-A-S-A-M-A-H. Nasama. Not nasim. That is nasama. And what is nasama? So Imam says, Rahimahullah, yes, subhanAllah, what a man he was. Because most of his knowledge, that was a gift and knowledge by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He was inspired by Allah. Subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he said, Huwa al-Bukhar, al-Latif, al-Mutawallad, fil-Qalb. Nuruddin should write it, al-Bukhar, al-Latif, al-Mutawallad, fil-Qalb. That is the stream. What? The steam. Which is created there inside the human body. Because of blood circulation. Because of what? Blood circulation. Because every moving entity, it needs steam. It needs moving is coming because of steam. Because of what? Because of steam. Yes, your car is running. Because of what? Steam. It is not because of gas and gasoline. Gas and gasoline, it functions, it creates steam. It creates, and then it pushes the car. Got it? Same is the human body or animal body. Yes, that is alive because of that steam. Got it? So that is called nasama. That's called nasama. And he said, Imam said, Rahimahullah, that in medical field, the doctors and the tabibs, they name that Bukhar and steam as Ruh. That is Ruh. That steam is Ruh. He said that is easy to approach. That's why they called it Ruh. Got it or not it? Because they are talking about matter and physics. They're talking about what? Matter and physics. And the actual Ruh is neither matter nor physics. Yes, physical sciences. They do talk about immaterial things. They do not. They have nothing to do with immaterial things. They say we have to discuss a thing which is either sensed, whether each is sensed or felt or weighed or measured. something which is neither sensed, nor felt, not measured, nor weighed. We have nothing to do with. So have you ever seen Einstein that he was talking of God? Tell me. Yes. Have you ever heard about Einstein that he was making research on God? No, God is not material. He has nothing to do with immaterial things. God is not an entity. You can weigh it, you can measure it. Yes. God is not it. So that's why they are not talking about these things. We have nothing to do with that. We do not believe in scientifically in such like things. Same is the case of that Ar-Ruh Rabbani, the actual spirit and soul. The actual spirit and soul. And as that is beyond the approach of common human being. So that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Surah Bani Israel. Ayah number 85. And they ask you about soul and spirit. The Jew people, they asked Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about what? Yes. That what spirit and soul is actually. So they ask you about soul and spirit. Qul say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ar-Ruh min Amri Rabbi. Ar-Ruh min Amri Rabbi. That Ruh is the command of my Lord. That is what? That is the command of my Lord. Ar-Ruh min Amri Rabbi. Second meaning. That Ruh is a thing which is the affair of my Lord. That is not our affair. It is not our affair to talk about that. That is the affair of my Lord. It is known only to Allah. قُلْ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي وَمَا أُوْتِيْتُمْ مِنَ الْغِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. And you have not been given knowledge but very little. In everything, and especially about Ruh, you have been given very little knowledge. You have been given very little knowledge about what? Ruh. And that's why you are calling that steam as Ruh. That steam is, so Imam says, Rahimahullah, actually that steam is the ride for Ar-Ruh Rabbani. You can write it. That is the ride, R-I-D-E, Markab. That is the ride for actual spirit and soul. Got it? And body is the ride for Nasama. Human body, that is what? That is the ride for Nasama. So Imam says, Rahimahullah, this face of Nasama, which is towards our body, this face of Nasama, which is towards our body, which is connected to our body, that is animal nature. That is what? Animal nature. And the other side of Nasama, which is connected to Ar-Ruh Rabbani, that is the angel nature. You should write it. This face of Nasama is animal nature. That face of Nasama, that is angel nature. Not right and left. That this side of Nasama, which is towards our body, which is facing our body, this is animal. And the other side of that Nasama, other face of that Nasama, which is towards Ar-Ruh Rabbani, that is angel nature. Got it? Now when the Nasama is disconnected from body, you should write it. When the Nasama is separated from body, that is called death. That's called what? Death. Steam is gone. Blood is no more flowing there in arteries and veins. Got it? That is death. Got it? But still, the Nasama, to some extent, that is still exist, and it has a connection to Ar-Ruh Rabbani. It has a connection to Ar-Ruh Rabbani. So whatever functions the organs were doing, whatever functions The organs were doing. We were seeing through what? Eyes. We were hearing through ears. We were speaking through our tongue. Yes? Now, through that, Ar-Ruhu Rabbani, the Nasama gets this power to some extent. You should write it. The Nasama gets these powers to some extent. So engrave, where? Engrave, in qabr. It sees and feels the azab and the comfort as well. Yes, it hears, it sees, it feels, it cries. Got it? And that's what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, a practical Muslim who had so much concern about every single prayer of him not to miss it, especially the Asr prayer, especially the Asr. If you are involved in your business at Asr time, yes, and the sun has become yellow and pale, it's going to disappear. So at that time, you hurry not to miss Salat Asr. Got it? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, in Qabr, the same thing happened to a practical Muslim. The sun, yes, is seen to him at it has become yellow and pale and it is disappearing. Yes, so he says to the angel, Da'uni usalli, leave me to pray my Salat Asr. I'm going to miss my Salat Asr. So it means the Nasama is speaking. The Nasama in Qabr is speaking. Got it or not it? Say, got it or not it? Our Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if he is a practical Muslim, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders his angels, iftahu lahu baban ila jannah, open a window towards paradise. Yatihi min naseemiha. So he may have the naseem there. Yes. Got it? The fragrance. Naseem means that wind which is bringing what? The good fragrance. So it means he feels. So who feels it? The Nasama. Who feels it? The Nasama. Got it? Our Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that the disbeliever in his grave or wherever he is after his death, he is beaten by the angel bimirzibbatim min hadidin, with a sledgehammer. With what? With a sledgehammer. Fayasihu sehatan. He cries to his utmost. Yasma'uhu man yalihi illa thakalain. يَسْمَعُهُ مَيَّلِهِ إِلَّا الثَّقَلَيْنِ. Every creature hears his cry except jinn and ants. That's a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maybe some of you have observed some time or not you. I observed once. I observed some time back. When I was in school, I think I was in elementary school or in middle school, at most. Yes. So my mom bought me two small goats, to play with and to have it and to be happy with. Yes. So after school, I used to take them both to graze somewhere. So once I took them to the close by cemetery, because a lot of grass was there and the plants are there. You know what I'm saying? So suddenly, these both small goats, they were running like crazy. They started running like crazy. Yes, and I was behind them, so I may not lose them and things like that. Anyhow, they were crying. So I was thinking, maybe something is there, but nothing was there. So then I related the story to my grandfather. So he told me, maybe the guy in Qabr, he was beaten and he cried, and that's why they ran away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive and forbid. In a hadith, Ibn Abbas says, radiyallahu ta'ala an, we were with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was riding his mule. And suddenly we were passing by six graves somewhere. And suddenly that mule started jumping. Fakadat an tulqiyahu. That mule was very close to throw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at the ground. Fasakanat. But it became calm. Got it? So we said, O the messenger of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, this mule has never done this type of practice. But it did it today. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ أَصْحَابَ هَذِهِ الْقُبُورِ يُعَذَّبُونَ. People in these graves, they are punished. And they were crying, and because of their cry, my mule started jumping. May Allah forgive and forbid. Say Ameen. Got it, not it, bought it, shot it, caught it. Yes.
وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحُ. And they ask you about soul and spirit. قُلْ سَيُّ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي. Soul and spirit is the order and command of my Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or that is the affair or the subject of Allah, not our subject. That is not our subject. وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. And you have not been given knowledge but only a little.
You have been given a little knowledge about this subject. Got it? Yes. So, رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, the Lord of the universe. So as you know, that we mentioned about Rabb, that he is the provider. He is the sustainer. He is not providing food to our bodies or needs of our bodies. He has provided us the need of our soul and spirit as well. And as you know, you should write it, that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he was going to create Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, so he ordered Jibreel alayhi salam to rake the surface of the whole earth with his right hand. He raked it. He gathered together the dust. And then, فَعُجِنَتْ بِالْمَيَاهِ الْمُخْتَلِفَ. That dust from all around the surface of the globe, it was made a dough for 40 years. How many years? Constantly and continuously. The rain was going on. Yes. And the big horses. What? The big horses. That is only to make us to understand. Otherwise, I'm very much sure these are dinosaurs. These are what? Dinosaurs. Because in that quagmire, no any other animal was able to jump. But dinosaur, yes, the way its structure is, nothing will happen to it in quagmire. Yes. It will never get stuck in quagmire. So they were jumping therein. Ibn Abbas says, Raziallahu ta'ala, but he mentioned what? Big horses. Because if he would have told the people of Arabia, yes, the dinosaurs were jumping therein. What is dinosaur? How it looked like? You know what I'm saying? So he said what? The big horses were jumping therein. And such like things, when a Sahabi said, which could not be sensed through intellect, so that is, in quwa of hadith, that he has heard it from whom? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. These things could be known only through wahi. You know what I'm saying? So they were making it a dough. Making, you know, dough. You know flour or not? To make bread. Yes, so they make it D-O-U-G-H. Is it? Got it or not it? So then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he made there from the structure of Adam alayhi salatu wa salam. Now I was looking in a hadith. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Inna Allah khalaqa Adama ala suratihi. Khalaqa Adama ala suratihi. Tuluhu sittuna zira'an. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam ala suratihi. Now here the word he, that's a pronoun. That's what? Pronoun. Yes, on his own shape. His own shape. Whose own shape? So there are two interpretations. Means ala suratihi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam on the own shape of Adam, because such like shape and structure was not known in the world for any other creature as it was given to Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. So it means that that is utmost or ultimate beautiful structure in the creature of Allah. لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ Fi ahsani taqweem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, indeed, we have created human in a very beautiful structure. In what? In a very beautiful structure. Such a beautiful structure, no any other creature has. Material creature, yes, does not have such a beautiful structure. So one meaning. Another meaning, Allah has created Adam on his own shape, Allah's shape. Now we are not going to explain it. How is the shape of Allah? Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we can say this is a tabir of beauty. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made human as beautiful as Allah is beautiful himself. Yes, as Allah is beautiful himself. So it means that Allah created Adam very beautiful. Human being, very beautiful. Tuluhu sittuna zira'an. Yes, he was tall 60 yards. Adam was tall 60 yards. So this is yard, 18 inches. How much? 18 inches. And in another hadith, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that his chest was wide by 7 yards. His chest was wide by what? By 7 yards. And as it is mentioned in hadith, that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he brought him out of garden in Jannah along with his wife. Yes, so he came down from garden where in Sri Lanka, in Jazair-e Sharqul Hind. It's called what? Jazair-e Sharqul Hind. Yes, the eastern islands of India. Eastern islands of India. Jazair-e Sharqul Hind. Nowadays that is called Sri Lanka. In Sri Lanka, there is a hill, a mountain. Yes, the Jews are going there. The Christians are going there. The Muslims are going there. The Buddhists and the Hindus are going there. Yes, on the hilltop there is a rock. There is what? There is a rock. And there are curved feet of someone in the rock. Like the one we have in Maqam Ibrahim. The feet of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam is curved there on that stone, which is in Mecca, in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On that mountain, the hilltop, a big rock, 2 feet are curved therein like a somebody is standing in a wet mud. Got it? So the Jew, the Christian, and the Muslims are going with one concept. Yes? The Hindus and the Buddhists, they are going with another concept. They both are of the view that these are the feet of Gautam Buddha. Buddha. They call him what? Buddha. Actual name is Gautam Buddha. That these are, but Gautam Buddha as a whole is only 6 feet or less than 6 feet. 5'10". 5'10". Now, how much is the length of these 2 feet? That is 6 feet. Yes, every foot is 6 feet. You know what I'm saying? So we should not call it foot. We should call it 6 foot. Got it? Foot is foot because most probably that is inside the foot. Yes, 8 inches, 9 inches, 10 inches. Yes, only the big guy with basketball, he is 14 inches. Yes, his number is what? That is how much? 21, yes. So anyhow, now it doesn't make sense that somebody who is only 6 feet, his foot is also 6 feet. Does it make sense? Does it? No. The Jew, Christians, and the Muslims, they are going to visit these 2 feet. Yes, that these are the feet of Adam, alayhi salatu wasalam. And that peak is called Adam Peak. Yes. That hilltop is called Adam Peak. So now, his body was made of dust from all around the earth, which was raked by Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam. The red, the black, the brown, the sand, the black sand, the white sand, every type of dust was there in that stuff, because the whole surface was there. And he said, fa'ujinat, Imam Sayyuti narrates, fa'ujinat bil mayahil mukhtalifa, and different types of water are used therein. Because rainwater is different type of water. You know what I'm saying? The water we are using, that is getting evaporated in one way or the other. The river water is getting evaporated. The sea water is getting evaporated. And the rain is falling down because of that evaporation. You know what I'm saying? So, minhu at-tabay'u al-alwan, Imam Suyuti says that colors and complexion are different because of different colors of dust. Yes. And nature is different because of different types and different natures of water. Different nature of waters. Got it? So nobody knows where from his dust came and where from his water came. Yes. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He built up His structure, and that structure was there in the valley of Naaman. Valley of Naaman. In Arafat, there is a valley that's called Naaman. So Satan, he came, and he looked at him, at the body. He entered from his right nostril. He visited all around his body, the veins and the arteries. Yes, the hose and the pipes were there. Plumbing. Yes, your plumbing, which is broken. Copper or galvanized? That was not copper or galvanized. That was made of dust. Got it? So he visited all around the veins and arteries and came out of this nose. And then he was standing looking at him. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him control over me, I will never obey him. I will never obey him. And if he will give me control over him, yes, so I know all around where the pipes are going. I will be flowing all around inside his body. Got it? And that's what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ يَجْرِي مِنَ الْإِنسَانِ مَجْرَ الدَّمْ. Shaitan approaches those points of human body where the blood flows. Wherever the blood flows, Shaitan approaches that area. He is going with blood flow. He is going because already he did survey. He did survey before. He did survey of our inside body in shape of Adam, alayhi salatu wasalam. So he is visiting every single point inside of our body. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam said, "Wa inna kulla insanin ma'ahu shaitan." Every insan has a Satan with him. That's a test. So Sahaba Rizwanullah alayhim ajma'in, they asked the Messenger of Allah, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, wa ma'aka ya Rasulullah, you also have a Satan with you? Yes, somebody who is twice or 24/7. So we say he does not have Satan. What we say about him? He doesn't have Satan. And certain people, they are in masjid, but still Satan is accompanying them. Even in masjid, in prayer, in ibadah, everywhere, Satan does not allow them and leave them alone. May Allah forgive and forbid. Yes. At least we throw our shaitan outside. When we come here, so we tell him, guy, dirty guy, just, yes, we are coming out. Then you should join us. Yes? But some people, they are of the view, don't leave me alone. Come inside. Be with me here. So anyhow, Sahaba asked the Messenger of Allah, "Wa ma'aka ya Rasulullah, you also have one?" Because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not committing any sin. Day and night, 24/7, he was not committing any sin. Yes. So they asked him, "And you also, O the Messenger of Allah, you also have one?" So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam smiled and he said, "Walakin Allah manna alayya fa aslama." Walakin Allah manna alayya. Allah did me a favor, so my Satan surrendered to me. My Satan surrendered to me. Fala yamuruni illa bi khair. He is the only Satan that he is whispering to me only good things, not bad. Yes, even my Satan, he is telling me, time of prayer, let's go. Got it? Not it or bought it? Yes, when you have control over Satan, so then the Satan will call you towards Deen. Yes, and when the Satan, he will have control over you. So in your prayer, Satan will be calling you towards Shaitanat. They do Shaitanat. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raja'un. So anyhow, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent the spirit and soul to the body of Adam. from a place known by the name of Haziratul Qudus. That is written like this. Haziratul Qudus. In Arabic, Haziratul Qudus. In English, enclosure of sanctity or enclave of sanctity. Enclave of sanctity. So all the human spirits and souls are there in Haziratul Qudus. Those who are born, their spirits and souls have come down. Those who are not born yet, their spirits and souls are staying there. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, يُجْمَعُ أَحَدُكُمْ فِي بَطْنِ أُمِّهِ أَرْبَعِينَ يَوْمًا نُطْفَى. For 40 days, every one of you stays as a mixed discharge of two waters in the womb of your mother. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that for another 40 days, ثُمَّ تَكُونُ عَلَقَةً مِثْلَ ذَلِكَ. That's a frozen blood for another 40 days. Transform into blood. ثُمَّ تَكُونُ مُضْغَةً مِثْلَ ذَلِكَ. Then that is just like a gum or flesh of meat for another 40 days. Got it? Now these are 4 months. 40, 40, 40. 120 days. How many months? 4 months. ثُمَّ يُرْسِلُ اللَّهُ الْمَلَكُ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends down an angel from Haziratul Quds, and he is bringing the soul and spirit to that body. So that angel enter into the womb of mother and he blows that. Yes. And now, yes, the baby inside. Yes. Jumping like this. Got it? Not it or bought it? Yes. So that spirit and soul is coming down where from? From Haziratul Qudus or enclave of sanctity. Got it? Now look, our body came where from? The ground, the earth. So all its requirements are coming there from as well. Where from the body is. We are taking food, where from? The ground. Drink, where from? The ground. Medicine, where from? Say, the ground. Dress, where from? The ground. And going back, where? To the ground. Because that is body. But our spirit and soul has come from upon the seven heavens from enclosure of sanctity. So now as our body has requirements, spirit and soul has requirements as well. So its requirements came down there from in shape of wahi. In shape of wahi. So this holy Quran and teachings of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is the food and the energy and the vitamin and all of its requirements of our ruh and spirit. Got it? So if you want to strengthen your body, take things therefrom. If you want to strengthen your spirit, take things therefrom. Come to Quran, listen to it. It will strengthen your spirit. It will strengthen? Yes. You know what I'm saying? Your body is getting strength and energy from things provided there from the ground. Yes. But your ruh will get energized and satisfied when you will be taking food from something which has come down from that area, from that world. And that is what? The Holy Quran and teachings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Got it? So Rabb is one who is providing both types of provision. Rabb is one who is providing both types of provision. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in world of spirits, Surah Al-A'raf.
وَإِذَا خَزَ رَبُّكَ مِنْ بَنِي آدَمَ. And remember when your Lord brought forth from the children of Adam, مِنْ زُهُورِهِمْ, from their backs, زُرِّيَّتَهُمْ, from their backs, their offsprings.
So the souls and spirits in the world of spirit, they were, Nabi Kareem, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in a hadith, كَأَمْثَالِ الذُّرْ. كَأَمْثَالِ الذُّرْ. You know the small ants. The small ants. And in these small ants, there is a red one. The red one is the smallest type of ant. There is a black one, that's a little bit big. But the red one is the smallest one. And its color is shining. Its color is... So these spirits and soul were, they were moving and shining like the small ants. They were moving and shining there. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Kun! So all these trillions and zillions ruh and spirits, they were there. And they were moving like what? The small shining red ants. Got it? And there is a story in hadith. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that Adam alayhi salatu wa sallam, yes, the great grandfather, he was amongst them. So he was looking at all of them. Yeah, subhanallah. How many children I will be having? These zillions and trillions of offspring until the day of judgment. Yes. So Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that suddenly, yes, he picked one of them. He was very much shining. So he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the spirit of Adam, asked Allah subhanahu, who is this one? Or who will be this one? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him, Haza ibn Daud alayhi salatu wa salam. This is one of your sons. His name is Daud. He will be the prophet of Israel. He will be the prophet of children of Israel. Yes. And Daud alayhi salatu, his complexion was very shining. He was a very handsome man. So Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَقَدْ جَعَلْتَ مِنْ عُمْرِهِ. How much is his age? How much his age will be in that world? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, سِتُّونَ سَنَةً. 60 years. He will be living in that world? 60 years. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Adam said, فَآتِهِ مِنْ عُمْرِ أَرْبَعِينَ سَنَةً. If you can please give him 40 years of my age, so he should complete one century. And Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, his appointed age was 1,000 years. So he said that give him 40 years of my age. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, done. This is a word I do not refuse the dua of anybody. And you ask me and you are the prophet. So that is done. And that is said when millions of years later, millions and millions of years later, when Adam was created, he was in this world. When he completed 960 years, so the angel of death approached him. He said, how you are here before time? He said, no, I am here in time. I am here in time. So Adam alayhi salatu wasalam said, "Aw ma bakiya min umri 40 sana." Still I have another 40 years to live here. Because my age is 1,000 years. My age is, now I am only 960. So the angel of death told him, "Aw ma qad a'taytahu ibnaka Daud? Have you not given the same 40 years to your son Daud?" So in million years, Adam alayhi salatu wasalam had forgotten that. Yes, fanasiya. He forgot wajahada. And he denied that, no, I have not given it to anybody. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam says, fanasiyat zurriyatuhu wajahadat. Fanasiyat zurriyatuhu wajahadat. Why we do forget? Genes. Because our Baba forgot. Who forgot? And sometime, why we deny? Because Baba denies. He forgot and he denied. Yes. And we deny without forgetting. Yes. He forgot because of what? He denied because of? He forgot. But we deny because of? No forgot. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala rasooli Muhammadin wa alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Allahumma rabbana alhamdulillah bil Qur'an zidna zakirna bil Qur'an ma nasina. Wa allimna minhu ma jahilna wa salatina wa ta'ana alayhi wa na'an nahar. Fallahu khayran hafizah.